Доброго ранку, дорогі друзі!
Здравствуйте, наші рідні браття і сестри! Ми раді привітати вас, а також всіх тих, хто дивиться онлайн.
We are very glad to see you in our church. Welcome to our celebration.
Шановні брати та сестри, ми маємо велику честь і нагоду оголосити урочисте відкриття 21-ї річниці
посольства благословенного Царства Божого для всіх народів. Брати та сестри українці, а зараз запрошуємо вас підвестися для виконання державного гімну України. Пишаюся країною, в якій живу, і її народом теж пишаюся. Кожен день, не у вісні, а наяву, до спільної мети ми разом наближаємось.
Я пишаюся незламністю сердець, відданістю, мужністю, завзяттям. Тим, що серце каже, це ще не кінець. Ми збудуємо процвітання браття.
Ми здолаємо усе-усе на світі. Ненависть, війну, занепад, крах. Ми повинні передати дітям Україну в інших кольорах.
В кольорах надії, радості і миру. В кольорах любові, розквіту і сил. Ми повинні будувати без почину землю, у яку сам Бог нас поселив.
Ми повинні принести у світ цей спокій, милосердя і добро. І молитвою змити все безчестя, що на України плечі налягло.
Ми збудуємо країну, про яку так мріємо, про яку писав святий Тарас. Незалежну, вільну, гідну, щиро.
Бо для Божих справ настав вже час.
До речі, це є авторський вірш Вікторії Мурич.
Дякую, Романе. Ви можете присісти, дорогі друзі. Ми віримо, що Бог не даремно прийшов на Україну. Ми віримо, що не буває ситуацій, у яких не може прославитися Господь. Ми віримо, що останнє слово за Ним, за Творцем неба і землі, за нашим Спасителем.
Адже усі ці роки Він вів нас і ніколи не залишав. Тому зараз, як ніколи, час покладати наші надії на Господа. Адже у своєму слові Він сказав: «Я вас не залишу і не покину».
А коли так, то маємо радіти перед Господом, бо в радості наша сила. До того ж є причини радіти, адже на наше свято завітали неабиякі співучі і талановиті гості.
Тож до вашої уваги, дорогі друзі, представляємо хор посольства Божого і під керівництвом Дмитра Кошеля.
Зустрічайте оплесками.
Dear friends, let's give your applause to this beautiful choir, which is called the Flower of Ukraine. They will go on enjoying our ceremony and will give the entertainment to you. Glory be to Jesus, to our Lord. Please sanctify our thoughts and all our life. Let's worship our Lord. And the glory be to Jesus. Please sanctify our thoughts and all our lives. God created Embassy of God Church in Ukraine and called Sandy, his son, to Ukraine for the glory of God and the power of God to come to Ukraine. For him to stand in the gap for our nation. Me, you, we go after our Lord. We are the army of Embassy of God Church. We will bring the truth all around the world and will make the mark in the history. And we will carry love and truth all around the world and will make our mark in the history. And in the time of persecution, we will flourish. And when there was persecution, curse, and scorns, God checked us, tested us. Me, you, we follow the Lord. We are the army of Jesus in the Embassy of God Church. We bring love and truth all around the world, and we will make our mark in the history. The nation changed, Ukraine changed, either. God renewed our generation through Embassy of God Church. The generation who follow Jesus Lord. Me, you, let's follow our Jesus Lord. We are the army of Jesus in the Embassy of God Church. Love and truth we bring to the whole world, and we will make our mark in the history. Today, here is celebration in the Embassy of God Church. There are many gifts. And in this temple of God, we are gathered together to praise the Lord. Me, you, he, we will follow the Lord. We are the army of Christ in the embassy of God Church. We bring love and truth all around the world and will make the mark in the history. Me and you, we follow Jesus Lord. We are the army of Jesus Christ. And let's bring love and truth to the whole world. And let's make our mark in the history. You have not only gave us enjoyment, but you all also helped us to tune up to the worshiping and praise. Victoria, why do you like to praise the Lord? I like praising Him for His love, for His commitment. For He didn't come down from the cross, but He was thinking about me and my eternity there on the cross. And how do you love Jesus and why do you praise Him? Just because He gave me forgiveness and redemption from all our sins. You know, Roma, there are many reasons to praise the Lord now, because the Lord of the Lords, God of Gods, is now here. And let's now together, let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, church, good morning. Good morning, let's praise the Lord. Stand up. Let's dance before our Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to you, God. Hallelujah. Let's sing to Him. Let's dance before Him for His mercy.
Народы все и царства. Сердцами будем петь, 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 вместе с небесами воздавать хвалу и славу. Будем петь, 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 благодарными сердцами.
Hallelujah, let's praise the Lord.
Приходим к тебе с хвалой, во врата твои.
входим с пением, приходим тебе с хвалой. По вратам твоим входим празднуя и благодаря за все. Небеса ликуют с нами, силу нам дают. Мы поем аллилуйя и ликуя воздаем тебе хвалу. Ты достоин всей хвалы, слава тебе и честь. Воздавать хвалу, о, для чего мы все.
Praise the Lord. Burst in applause to the Lord. Glory be to you, Jesus. Let's dance before Jesus.
Украина!
Glory be to you, Jesus. We send glory to you from the earth. I don't see your hands. Please clap to the Lord. To our God, to our Creator, to our Redeemer, to our Savior, to our Lord. You are great, and may glory be to you eternally. We exalt your holy name, God. We glorify your holy name. We praise you.
Слава Богу, прийняй
God, you are the only one. You are in heaven. You are the Lord on the earth. You are the Lord of our lives. You are the Lord of our souls. Let's praise the Lord in our hearts, in this house. Give salvation to all the nations, and we are grateful to you for this, and we lift you up high. We bring you all glory. We give you all the praises only to you, Holy. Glory be to you. Christ, praises be to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give praises to the Lord. Give praises to the Lord. Burst in applause to the Lord. Glory be to you, Jesus. All the glory to you, great God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to you, Jesus. Glory be to you, Jesus. Amen.
Давайте ми дадимо Богу ще славу.
Let's give our hands to the Lord now. Let's give him our hands. Hallelujah. And let's keep standing, please. Let me invite onto the stage a musical ensemble which is called Art Creative. Clap to them, please. And they will perform a song which is called We Wish You Happiness.
Thank you.
The nightingale is singing out of the window in our village. You're welcome in this village. Many trees are in blossom here, and there are many beautiful girls and handsome boys. And once you have come here, you will never want to leave it. We wish you happiness, and we wish you for love to warm you. For the scenes to be performed under your window. We wish you joy to fill your day and your life each day. We're happy that we were born here, and these mountains bring us life. I'm happy that I'm on my own land. I wish you to be rich for good deeds, for the peace to be on your earth. God, give us happiness. And we wish you happiness, for the love to warm you, for the songs to be performed under your window. May peace be in our land. May joy fill you each day in all your life. We wish you happiness, and may love warm you, for the scenes to be performed under your window. May joy fill you each day in your life. Many people know that Ukrainians sing very well, and so let's thank this art creative ensemble and Helen Stebelska. He is the leader of this ensemble. Let's clap to them. But our presents haven't finished yet. Now, Liza Usok will perform to you. Welcome her with your applause. Dear Church, I congratulate you with the opening of the anniversary, and this song will be dedicated to you, and may the presence of the Lord be in this celebration. Thank you very much, and let me invite onto the stage people who are ready to testify what God has done in their lives. You are welcome to the stage, please. Please share what God is doing in your life and how you see God in your life. Congratulations to you, dear church, and let me testify about the glory of God in my life. I'm a mother of three children, and when I bore a son, and when I was on the ninth month of pregnancy, the doctors diagnosed a very bad disease, and that disease was in my breast, in the cell of my breast. And you know that all the organs in the body are interconnected. And and almost all my organs were, you know, infected by this disease. And the doctors started to press me, put pressure on me, and they wanted me to make abortion because my child had to be born as an invalid, and they said, why do you need an invalid? It's better to make an abortion. And when I said that I will not go for abortion, and the doctor said, oh, you're holy, and, you know, with an irony on his face. And the doctor started blackmailing me, saying that if you don't make an abortion, then this disease can provoke early birth. And they provided some analysis, and that analysis was very, very dangerous, but God saved my child, and I thank God for my pastor, for my leader. I have been in the church since 1998. This is my pastor, Лариса Криворучка. She was praying for me, for my child, and she was sowing the seeds of faith, supporting me, encouraging me, and my child, you know, could have been born either ill or could have died, but God blessed the operation, and the delivery was very, very hard, and I had to do a cesarean section.
And I thought,
and my child, when I was delivering him,
12 hours,
the waters from my belly was going out. And after cesarean section, the child was born totally healthy. So, unfortunately, some problems. My child was in the resuscitation for a while, you know, and after such a disease, usually 85% of children die, and, you know, the doctors also wanted to do some surgery operation to my child, because then it was discovered that he had some disease, and that operation was successfully done. Unfortunately, the dysplasia of the lung was discovered by the doctors that back then, but now he is 8 years old. But you know what I want to say, that when my child just was in my womb, I was praying, but now I can see how he's going to school, how he's working, and God was helping me all our lives. When the child was born, we had also the bad partition in the heart, and God healed him from this disease. And also doctors testify about positive dynamic in the healing process, and he's a normal child in his 8 years old. When he was born, there was a problem in his lung, and there was only a part of a left lung, and nowadays his left lung is full. Of course, it doesn't work completely well, but he is growing, he goes to the swimming pool, his body gets stronger and stronger. And you know, when I was praying, God showed me my child as a strong one, as an adult already. And if you could see my child, and you would say that in his 8 years old, he looks as if he is 10, and he is thinking as if 36-year-old man. You know, when we get a problem, devil tries to stick us to this problem. But I want to testify and prove this testimony that this child grows each day, each minute. He develops perfectly well, and I testify that God was with her all this time. And the story goes on with the following post-story, what was after.
проходя всі ці трудності, Бог
While I was undergoing this hardships, God gave me a desire to serve such families and mothers with children with bad diagnoses. And when I came to Pastor Лариса, and she said to me, "Don't you want to deal with such families and mothers?" You know, and I agreed because I had a desire to grow, to develop, and I was a home group leader, and I had a desire to promote, and therefore I took responsibility for such families. I collected a team, and we discussed what we can do for these families. And now we cover different children houses, infant houses. We collaborate with the social departments in our region. Now I'm a member of a group of MP in our local council. I'm also a leader and the head of NGO, which is called Feel the Heart. And my problem helped me to collaborate with many institutions and help others to overcome these diseases and problems. Nowadays, I'm invited to many public events, and many raffles are held with my works, and they are sold for very high prices. And my story is an alive testimony about the wisdom of God. And I'd like to say that all these problems, all the persecution, all the hardships I went through, they became a firm ground for my calling and service. Thank you very much, Church. Thank you. Good morning, Church. Congrats to you. I would like to thank God for our church, Embassy of God Church, because if not for this church, I wouldn't be alive. 14 years ago, I came to the church being a drug addict. And I'd like to thank God for my mother, who was praying for me for 3 years. And when I came to the church, I was delivered from this drug addiction, and I'd like to thank Pastor Anton Litvin and Tatiana Litvin, because they gave me a push in my first years of Christianity. And also, Pastor Larisa Krivoruchka has been my pastor for 12 years already. She helps me, she encourages me, she helps me when I face adversities. And, you know, the values which the church gave me, they transformed my mentality. And I'm grateful to God that I have a good family, and that God gave me understanding that I'm not just a former drug addict, but I have my calling. I entered a university, I graduated from it, and got higher education in economy. I thank God that in this church we are formed as personality, as people who must be above but not on the bottom. And to date, the transformations happened in my life are seen not only to me, but also for the people who knew me before repentance and salvation. Nowadays, I'm a head of NGO where there are 200 members, and half of the members are those ones who knew me before I got salvation, and they made me a head of this NGO. This is the glory of God. And this glory says that the people who told me, you know, he went to sect, he was brainwashed by Pastor Sunday, and after a while, these people changed their attitude to God and to us as believers. They want to trust now more to us than to the secular people. For this, I'm grateful to God, and I'm thankful for Him that I can influence people and I can establish the principles and values of God, which Pastor teaches us through University of Life and books of University of Life. Thank you for my life, church. Thank you, but you haven't mentioned a lot. You have to say that you were a drug addict and you have now a successful business. You know, God does not only deliver us but also promotes us if we are loyal, if we don't seek comfort, if we are not in the vanity, but if we stick to God. And these testimonies will help us to increase the love to God. Let's praise the Lord for these testimonies. And after such testimonies, which we have just heard, that people had some problems, but God delivered them from these problems. And I would like now to appeal to the people in the hall, other people who have come for the first time to this church. This is an altar call. If you have never repented, if you have never confessed Jesus as your Lord, just raise your hand, lift your hands. If you have some addiction, or maybe your family is getting broken down, but if you have also maybe some disease, God can give you a miracle today. God can reveal Himself for you, and He can forgive your sins and restore you. I would like to invite all those who lifted their hands to the stage, to the front of the stage, please come. Please, people who wave their hands, please come to the stage. Or maybe you have noticed some people who have come to the church for the first time and they are shy to come. I'd like to tell you that this is your chance, and God wants you to reconcile with Him through repentance. You know, sin parts us from the Lord, and it's a chance for you to repent and reconcile with Him. I invite you, be bold enough to come. If you've brought some person to the church, please bring him or her to the stage or help him or her to come out. If you are still sitting or didn't manage to come to the stage, please, you have your time. Welcome you at our first service of such a great celebration. And we'd like today for you to reconcile with the Lord, for you to see the Lord as your God, and for Him to move in your life. And for every guest, we always have some gifts. And Svetlana Voloshina, a singer, will perform an interesting song to you. Keep standing and receive your gift. Hello, dear friends. Once I always stood on the same place where you are standing. And I'm thankful to God that I have been with the Lord for 17 years already. And now I'm going to sing about the Lord who didn't leave, who didn't abandon the cross, but helped us to get eternal life. And I offer you to make friendship with the Lord and be close to Him. The King of Kings, you are Almighty God. He didn't abandon the cross. The crucified King. He didn't abandon the cross. As I forgive you. God loves you. Be blessed.
Спасибо большое.
Thank you very much. This song was dedicated to you. And you know what? Now we want to talk to you after a while. And just look at this brother and follow him. You will now visit another room for us to communicate with you and for you to feel comfortable as if... Dear friends, and now we invite Юрій Ходаковський for the presentation of charitable fund, which is called Change One Life and Then Whole Ukraine. Glory be to God, dear church. Congratulations. Congratulations with the 21st anniversary. Welcome. I'm Юрій Ходаковський from Ivano-Frankovsk, city of Ukraine. My pastor is Pastor Vladimir Bondar. And my presentation will be about NGO, a movement called Change One Life, Change All Ukraine. I'm grateful to Pastor Sunday, for our church. And I'm grateful for our brother Леонид Лебедев, who created such charitable fund to change lives of people. They deal with orphan children, and he opened a house for orphans. And you know, it's very hard to penetrate this area and preach the gospel there. Now you will see on the screen what we are doing. It happened that we occurred in the infant house. Everyone has own future. A firefighter saved many lives. Olympic champion, chess player, designer of a very famous project, opera singer, investigator, volunteer in hot spots, cameraman, and chef. A child can grow even without the participation of the parents. But you can be a part of his life. Give a future to the child. Become his father or mother.
Nikita
was born in 2010. He was born a special, peculiar child.
He has some diseases
which stop him to develop speech. But he clearly understands everything he is told.
He hears
commands and fulfills them. He can play games. He can walk very well. He is very kind and tender. He kisses only those who he knows very well. And he seeks a very dear face, mother's face. Despite the fact that one person, very important person, betrayed him in life, he believes that someone can come into his life as his parents and beautify his life, and he can become a happy child. Change One Life. The contacts are on the screen. Dearly beloved, this is the presentation about our movement, and all the contacts are on the screen or at the office. I encourage you to access this website, enter our website and attend our webinars, listen to the information there, and adopt children. They need us. I congratulate you once again. Thank you. I love you.
Брати та сестри, зараз ми маємо небу честь представити вам спікера сьогоднішнього служіння.
Це людина, яка чи не з перших днів стоїть пліч-о-пліч зі старшим пастором церкви Посольства Божого Сандеєм Адоладжою. Людина, яка у своїй щоденній роботі проявила вірність та посвято.
Завдяки титанічним зусиллям цього служителя, щороку відкриваються нові церкви. А пастори їдуть на місію в різні країни та міста.
Як ви вже здогадалися, це єпископ об'єднаних церков Посольства Божого, директор місіонерського центру, глава духовного управління церков Євангельських християн України
Анатолій Тимофійович Білоножко.
Анатолій Білоножко, welcome.
Спасибо. Добрий день, дорога церковь, поздравляю вас.
Hello, dear church. Congratulate you with the 21st anniversary of our church.
Дайте Богу славу.
Praise the Lord.
Дайте славу тому,
хто спас нас.
Дайте славу тому, хто дає нам жизнь, дихання і все, що ми маємо. Хто дає нам дітей, хто дає нам здоров'я.
The one who gives us children, house,
and
all glory be to Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah. Дорогая церковь.
Dear church.
Вы можете присесть.
You may be seated.
Прежде всего я хочу
First and foremost.
Поблагодарить
let
нашего Господа Бога.
Thank our Lord Jesus Christ for this celebration, for the way we have undergone.
Есть смысл поблагодарить его.
Is there any sense to do this?
21 год это славный
путь нашей
церкви.
The way of 21 years is a great way. And of course, on this way we faced many
Что такой путь это путь великих
good things
людей,
and bad things.
But
I'm sure that this way
церквей.
Is the way of great churches. Praise the Lord.
Хочу поблагодарить всех вас за
I would like to appreciate all of you for your faith and for your dedication. That you are a part of our movement. I bless you all in this day, and I ask and wish for you to go on serving God and praising Him. Also praise the Lord to yourself and to the Lord. Turn to your neighbor and say, I congratulate you and thank you for everything.
Хочу также поблагодарить нашего пастыря Сандея.
And I'd like also to congratulate our pastor and thank him because he is our spiritual father. Through him I received Jesus and salvation.
Вашем присутствии говорю спасибо.
And in your presence, I tell you that I'm grateful to Pastor Sandy because he opened me the way to Jesus Christ. And the one who I am now, I am only thanks to Pastor Sandy. And sometimes we thank God, but God does his deeds through people. So therefore, I'm grateful to many people, other people, to you, Pastor Tapeo, to my comrades, to my collaborators, to Pastor Natalie Patapayeva. These people are changing me. And also want to appreciate Valentina Grigorievna. This is my first leader. Therefore, thank all of you, and I also want to appreciate all pastors, apostle members, members of Apostolic Council, bow down before you. Hallelujah!
О чём же я сегодня хочу проповедовать?
Do you know what I'm going to preach about today? This is the title. Prepare yourself for the future.
Приготовьте себя к будущему.
Prepare yourself for the future. The main idea, the bottom line of the preaching is it's not so important who we are now, but rather it's more important who we will become in the future. Let me repeat. It's not so important who we are now, rather who we will be in the future. And it's the 21st year in our church, and it seems that a huge distance was covered. And, you know, we had a fast with our apostles, and from our fasting we took one seed. It says that we are only starting our way yet. And Pastor Sunday says that he has only started living. And I tell you that our church has just started doing something, launching something. We are just on the start of our way, and the best things are ahead. And certainly, if everything is ahead, many projects and ministries are awaiting for us. And it's very important to be a part of this future. And we should be prepared well enough for this future not to trample us down into the earth. Am I right? This is very important to be ready. And for the future not to pass us by, for the future not to swallow us, we have to be prepared well enough. Preparation is a law of life. No matter how many years we live, we should prepare ourselves each day. This is the law the Creator created for all creatures. We should be ready for everything. All life, all stages of our lives show that we should be ready for everything. Even though you are 60 years old, you should be ready for the future. We prepare our children for the kindergarten, then for the school, primary school, for example. Am I right? And then when you need to enter the university, you should get ready for the university. And then you should prepare your children for the marriage, because without preparation, marriages break and collapse. We should be ready for the motherhood and fatherhood. You should be ready for this, how to become good mothers and fathers. And even when you want to become a grandfather, you should be also ready for this. You know, when I became a grandfather, I wasn't ready. I couldn't believe that I became a grandfather. So, therefore, I should catch up. And therefore, you should be ready and prepare yourself for being a grandfather. So, preparation is the most important part in our life. Our church just starts to influence and create. And if we mean this, we need preparation. Repeat this word, preparation. Let me quote Bible now. 1 Timothy 3:1.
Здесь написано, верно слово, если кто епископства желает, доброго дела желает.
It's written, here is a trustworthy saying, if anyone sets his heart on being an overseer, he desires a noble task.
Епископство здесь переводится как лидерство, как священство.
Bishop, the word bishop in Russian version of the Bible says that this is a noble position. A bishop is the one who cares about other souls, the one who cares about other people. So being a bishop, it means to be a caring person and serve other people, and this is to be a leader of others. Another translation of Bible, you know, there are many translations, and the more translations you read, the better. Another interpretation says, if someone wants to become a carer for others, this is good. And there is another interpretation. I may praise you if you want to become a manager in the church, means to be a leader in the church. Please understand that to become a leader in the church in the eyes of God is a good deed. So you have to get a desire to become someone in the church. You must get some desire to promote, to become someone in this church, some leader in the church. And to have this desire is good in the eyes of God. For example, to become a leader of NGO, or a leader of a people, of a home group, a leader of some movement, a ministry, to take responsibility for children, for example, or for homeless. It does not matter. Anyway, this is leadership is all about. This is bishophood is all about. God's word is faithful, those ones who want to become a bishop wants a good deed. So let's make this verse a ground for a preaching. You must have a desire to become someone in the church. If you don't want to promote, it means that you're out of the will of God, because the word of God says that we should desire, we should have a desire to promote and to achieve something. Therefore, you have to get some goals in life, some purposes, some aims in your ministry or in your achievements or growth. Long before, there was a saying, that soldier is a bad one who doesn't want to become a colonel or a general. And therefore, I may say that Christian is bad one who doesn't want to become an apostle or at least pastor. And I do believe that we are not bad, we are good. Repeat this word, I'm good. Therefore, if you are a good Christian, if you are a good soldier, and you must have a dream to become someone in the church, amen? What's the most important? You know, what's the most important in the preparation? What should we do? What are the crucial points we should fulfill? Is to form our personality, to form ourselves as a human, as a Christian, as the children of God, as the sons of this church. This is the most important. This is forming yourself, shaping out yourself. This is first and foremost point.
So,
if you want to see your future, you start working on yourself hard for us to become a personality from Big P. And why is there nothing on the screen? The first Timothy 4:6, it's written,
занимайся этим постоянно, ибо так поступая, и себя спасешь, и
for everything God created is good.
Чтобы спасти себя, еще и других людей вокруг себя, что надо
делать? You should, well, if you want to
изучать себя, вникать в себя,
to think of yourself, to think over yourself, change yourself.
Мало того,
and God says that you should form yourself all the time. Repeat these words all the time. Watch your life and doctrine closely. Preserve in them, because if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers. So, if you don't prepare, the future may either pass you or swallow you, trample you. Have you ever been in Europe or lived in Europe? Oh, you have just seen some pictures. There are many Europeans sitting in the hall, and you understand, you will understand that being a European, it means to be a hard worker. You know, if Ukraine wants to be a part of Europe, you should be prepared. Otherwise, it may break you. It's very important to know yourself better. Why is your wife upset? Is it not important? Or why are people upset after they visited my communion? Or why can I not do well or get along with people? Why am I irritated or argumentative, etc.? So, pondering over yourself, you will notice what you should work on. You will see what you should change. And this way, we compare ourselves with the image of the Lord.
Поэтому, если мы говорим о будущем, Если мы говорим, что подготовьте
себя к будущему, when we are speaking about the future and we want to prepare ourselves for the future, it means that forming yourself is the most crucial. Jesus didn't start his ministry until he formed a personality out of himself, until he developed some certain qualities in him which helped him to overcome all the persecutions, not that to swerve from the way, rather to stay on the way, and therefore he could stand all the adversities and he could overcome tests of the devil. And this is why he completed the will of God.
Поэтому скажите
соседу. Therefore, turn to your neighbor and say the forming of your personality is the most important for you.
Потому что люди женятся, выходят замуж.
Because some people get married.
Сформировав себя.
Though they haven't formed themselves yet. And you know their end. They conflict, they argue, and then they don't know what to do with it. They don't know how to overcome this problem. And therefore we have divorces. So what's the most important for us is the forming personality, establishing yourself. And I divided the formation of personality into four directions. This is formation of priesthood. Repeat this word, priesthood. And I consider if we form ourselves, we must form a priesthood in ourselves. In Hebrews, it's written, do your best to have peace with all and the holiness without which no one can see God. Pursue for no one to be deprived of the blessings and favor of the Lord, for no one to make bad, and for by with them the others would be sanctified. So what's the main point here? It's holiness. Without holiness, no one will see the Lord.
So therefore,
the holiness is the purity of our hearts. Holiness is the quantity and quality of the Lord in us. You know, priesthood is when you are parted from the sin. You are parted from the lawlessness of this world. Priesthood is the first and foremost condition why you can hear the voice of God. Priesthood is pastorhood, is serving people. Priesthood is when you give all yourself to the Lord and to service. Priesthood is your dedication to the Lord. Priesthood is to become a missionary, is to become a pastor, leader. Priesthood is to go and pray, right? Is to praise the Lord, is also priesthood is all about. And to be a worshiper to the Lord, it's also priesthood. Or to fast, for example, is also part of priesthood. So therefore, what should we form, develop in ourselves? They are the qualities of God in us, the qualities of Jesus in us. We should be thirsty of prayers, thirsty of listening to preachers, thirst to study new things, to worship, to praise, and we should find peace in this. We should search for the ways of the Lord. We should cleanse our hearts from the vices. If we found some vice, we should repent in that at once. Therefore, after repentance, we bring back the holiness to ourselves, and then we can hear the voice of God. And this is the preliminary and the most important condition. Therefore, when we are saying about formation of our personality, first of all, we should form a priesthood in ourselves.
Secondly, we must formulate our leadership qualities. Everybody say leadership.
Деяния, 20 глава, 28 стих. Написано: «Итак, внимайте себе и всему стаду, в котором Дух Святый поставил вас блюстителями пасти церковь
In Acts 9:28 it says, написано, So Saul stayed with them and moved about freely in Jerusalem, speaking boldly in the name of the Lord. So what does this make us?
Блюсти.
This makes us блюстителями, people who
пасти.
Lead.
То есть само Библия сама говорит,
and the Bible itself says
that
God set us as shepherds, and who are shepherds, they are leaders. They are already leaders. That means you're taking care of someone, you're giving someone information. That means you're a blessing for someone. That's why leadership is something that we must all strive for. This is what we must all formulate inside of us. A leader is always first. A leader always sees farther than the rest. He always understands more. And in the end, he knows more than the rest. Leadership is knowing how to motivate people, to attract people. It is to be on top. A leader keeps on learning, and he self-educates himself. He always finds something new to learn. And he always has something that others do not have.
Он воспитывает в себе системное мышление. Он воспитывает в себе стратегическое понимание вещей. Это лидерство.
Аминь.
Поэтому, если мы говорим о будущем, если мы говорим, приготовьте себя к будущему, прежде всего, мы должны формировать себя. В чем первое? Мы формируем священство. Второе, мы формируем лидерство. Аминь.
Бог Библия говорит,
чтобы мы Он поставил нас блюстителями пасти церковь
Божию.
Третье.
So third of all,
что мы должны формировать?
What must we
Всего
formulate?
Четыре я выбрал таких.
So only chose four main points.
Четвертое мы должны формировать в себе это третье, да?
So
третье мы должны
формировать
в себе веру,
inside of ourselves is faith,
характер,
character,
внутренний стержень.
And an inner core.
Я считаю, что наш характер только удерживает нас
I feel like
от
our
различных
character
давлений или внутренний
keeps
стержень
us away from
может удерживать
more pressure,
на правильном пути.
And that the inner core
знаете,
leads us towards the right direction.
Оттягивать.
Because in life there are
много
so many distractions,
уводить,
many things that will lead us away. There are lots of
strength что угодно,
that will lead us away from the truth,
что
lots of temptation.
Удержит?
But what will keep us
плаву,
going on the right
пути?
Path?
Это вера наша, наш
This is our faith, our character.
Сформированный внутренний
This is what
стержень.
We have formulated inside of us. This is our
В
core.
Книге Иисус Навин, 1 главе 9 стиха, Бог говорит,
And
вот
it says
я
in Joshua,
повелеваю тебе, будь тверд и
This is what I tell you. Be strong and courageous.
И не ужасайся.
Do not fear of anything.
С тобою Господь Бог
Because God is with
везде,
you
куда не
everywhere you go.
Вы знаете, нам нужно формировать эти
you know, we have to formulate these characteristics.
Например,
This is an ability, for example, to be patient.
Прощать.
It's the ability to forgive.
Противостоять
It is the ability to withstand all temptation.
Каким-то бедам, каким-то
any
информации.
Any wrong information.
Ну, наводить внутри порядок.
It is the ability to
навелось.
Cleanse yourself of all the bad that is within you. It is how to lead and have right thoughts. It is how to stand firm when everything is not going your way. When someone does not have a strong core, that means he is very weak. He has a weak faith, and he just goes to church only when everything is going well. And that's, of course, when God is doing well and when the church is doing well. But when this person goes through a hard time, everything is bad for him. He just leaves. He leaves the church because it is bad. He leaves God because it is bad. Also because he's very egoistic. And this type of person usually falls away, usually goes away.
Ну,
бросает семью, церковь, get rid of the church or do it rid of the family. And in order for this not to happen, we need to be ready for the future. We need to prepare ourselves
сформировать себе вот этот внутренний стержень.
Formulate inside of us this strong inner core. This is like how to be a human.
It
doesn't matter if you were lied to, or if you were betrayed, or if you were name called. If you lose your temper, that means you do not have this inner strong core. But when you can take control of all that anger that you have inside of you, that means you have this seed, this inner core, you have this strength. Because without that, you will not see the future. Without this, the future will squash most of our dreams. Because the world has so many ways, so many temptations of getting you off the right course. With pleasure, with entertainment. It's like, here, try this, or here, try this. Only with character. It is possible to withstand. Because this is what I noticed. When someone is at the bottom, it's like, oh, it's okay. It's like when someone became a little bit richer, saying, huh, I don't know how to approach this person.
That
means the riches have already changed him to someone you don't know who this person is. You look at him when he has all this money, you don't know who he is. He doesn't have all of God's values. Anything in the future can deceive and break a person. And the last thing we have to formulate inside of ourselves in order to welcome the future.
Скажите, зрелость. Вы знаете, зрелого человека сразу видно. Он не кричит.
We need to be mature. Because obviously you can see someone who is mature and someone who is not mature. Mature person does not whine. He does not complain over every small thing. And a mature person is stable and he has implemented God's values into his life. Because you can walk behind behind a mature person for a long time and you can complete lots of God's works.
Это послание к евреям, 11 глава, 24 стих. Верою Моисей, придя в возраст, переводится как «перейдет», он стал зрелым, он стал взрослым. Он что-то понял в своей жизни. Что-то до него дошло, открылось, такое, что другим было закрыто. И вот верой Моисей, придя в возраст, отказался.
Abel offered God a better sacrifice than Cain. By faith, he was commended as a righteous man when God spoke well of his offerings. And by faith, he still speaks, even though he is dead.
Почел большим для себя богатством, нежели египетские
сокровища. By faith, Enoch was taken from this life so that he did not experience death. He could not be found.
Но он взирал на воздаяние. Это тоже качество зрелого человека. То есть он больше для себя богатства предпочел исполнять волю Божью. Он больше для себя богатством почел, когда есть поношение. То есть все унижение. То есть он выбрал Божий путь, который, конечно,
and he also always goes in God's direction. And even though it is not always as doesn't seem as spectacular as the way of the world, it is still very effective. And if you ask many people, what did Moses do with his life? Many worldly people say, wow, how could he just walk away from being a pharaoh? He chose to suffer, to go to the desert for 40 years? That makes no sense. And yes, it is true, it makes no sense to all the unbelievers. But Moses became a great man, not because his name is Moses, but he became a Moses because he followed God. And this act of service was very useful to God. So when we are mature, we must have nothing else in our mind other than serving God. If we are people like Abraham or Moses, if we are like Jesus, if we are like the apostles, for them the first thing was God. It was His mission. It was trying to save everyone. So we have to ask ourselves, why was I saved? Why am I going to this church? What is my responsibility? What am I supposed to do with my life? How can I please you? This is the maturity that he's talking about in the Bible. A mature person becomes a servant. He honors other people. He respects other people. He doesn't search for ways to please himself. He searches for ways to please God. He always goes for God's way. Even if there may not be lots of money, they may not have lots of popularity, maybe you'll even be persecuted, they'll be calling you a fanatic, a heretic, and they're even giving tithes. You understand? But if you look at Moses, it was his choice. He would rather suffer than go against God's will. And through that, he received so many blessings. And this act is a true act of a mature person. A mature person can be a team player. He is not prideful enough to not give up his position as a leader. A mature person understands, he values relationships a lot. He values people. For him, the most important thing is that you are human. He looks more at your heart than your deeds. This is maturity. He understands that we're all a team, we're all a family, that you're not better than me, and I'm not better than you. We're all just one big family. So a mature people sees you with deficiencies, and he sees me with deficiency, but that doesn't matter, because we are a family. We love each other, we respect each other. And God only works through mature people. That is the only way he can fulfill his will. And we need mature husbands, right? We need mature fathers. We need mature mothers. We need mature Christians. We need this maturity.
So
this is what mature people value. So if we take this in the perspective of the future, we need to develop all these characteristics. And lastly, I will read what was in the very beginning. The sermon, prepare yourself for the future. The main thought is, it doesn't matter how we view ourselves now, but it only matters how we will be viewed in the future. So first of all, what do we formulate? Our purity. We must pray, we must fast, we must read the Bible. We must praise God, we must worship God. Second of all, what do we formulate? Leadership. We must all become leaders. Third of all, we must formulate our faith, our character, inner core. And fourth of all, we get rid of our immaturity and we become mature people with whom we can do the deeds of God. It doesn't matter who we are viewed as now. It's only important who we are viewed as in the future. Let's give God a round of applause. Once again, I congratulate you all with the 21st anniversary. May this short word just bless you.
So let
this not just be information, just remember this is very useful to you. And also, I want to call you to give tithe and donation to the construction of the church. Aren't you happy that you're in such a nice hall? This is our hall.
This is the building of our church. Who built it? We have built it for our own money. We all sow those seeds, and someone gave more or less, but I believe that this is our holy responsibility to solve the construction of own house. It's not someone's, but our house. It's so pleasant to see how your own spiritual house is being built. It's not pastor's house or someone's house. This is your house, and the doors of this house will be always open to you.
Now I want to pray for the tithe of this church. So, dear Father, I ask of you to bless all the giving of hands, that these seeds will bring lots of fruits. I ask of you, God, to bless everyone who is giving the last of their money, that you will give them in 30, 60, and 100-fold more, that all their financial problems will be fixed, that all their debts will be paid in the name of the Lord. I pray that all of our members of the church will have enough money to live and serve. And to you I give all the glory in Jesus' name and the Holy Spirit. And everybody says, Amen.
Please
be blessed.
Hallelujah. Хочемо подякувати вам, єпископи, за актуальну та живу
проповідь. Like to thank our bishop for such a good sermon and for delivering for us the word of God.
Почекайте, ми маємо подаруночок для вас.
And, hey, hold on, we have a present for you. May God bless you.
Через ваших учнів і піднімає вас.
And may he help many people through your teachings.
Здравствуйте, церков. Книги, да?
So, good morning, dear church.
Будьте благословенны.
Please be blessed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't hear you. I want to see your either hands or voices. Musicians, I don't hear you.
The drummers, where are you? This is sort of weak. Where are the drums? Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Слабо в залі.
It's weak in the hall.
Я не слышу.
I don't feel the intensity.
Смотри, що зробив Господь.
Look what the Lord has done. I want to praise his name. Each day is just the same. Come on and praise him. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He healed my mind. He saved me just in time. I want to praise his name. Each day is just the same. Come on and praise him. Look what the Lord has done. 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 He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I want to praise His name. Each day is just the same. Come on, youth, come out. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I want to praise His name. Every day is just the same. Come on and praise Him. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I want to praise His name. Each day is just the same. Come on and praise Him. Look what the Lord has done. When I think of all that He's done and how saved me, I just want to, I will jump, 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 jump. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body, He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I want to praise His name. Each day is just the same. Come on and praise Him. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. I want to praise His name. Each day is just the same. Come on and praise Him. Look what the Lord has done. Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I want to praise His name. Each day is just the same. Come on and praise Him. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I want to praise His name. Each day is just the same.
I will sing to him. I will rejoice that you saved me, and I will sing to you forever because you saved me. I will not get tired of praising you and dancing to you. Inside of me, your fire is inflaming in me, and I will cry to you, shout to you. He loves me and he is always with me. Sing forever because you saved me, and I will not be tired to dance for you and praise Jesus. Inside of me, his fire is flaming in me, and I will shout that I know that he loves me and he is always with me.
Я без конца. присутні все. В Ісусі щастя.
Happiness is in Jesus.
Громко восклицайте все.
Raise your voices and say, happiness is in Jesus. There's so much glory of God here. And give praises to the King. Hallelujah. My God, I love you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, my God, I love you. Jesus is my Lord, and I will praise Him. Jesus is my Lord, and I will praise Him. The Lord. Jesus is the Lord. He is God of the earth and heaven. This is why we win. Jesus is the Lord of the earth and heaven. This is why we win. Jesus is the Lord and God of the earth. This is why we get victory. Jesus is the Lord, and I will praise Him. Jesus is the Lord, and I will praise Him. Jesus is God of the earth. This is why we win.
Jesus God.
Jesus is the Lord. This is why we win. Hallelujah. God, we thank you for another year on the earth.
God admit it.
To celebrate another year and to put a stamp of your presence on the earth, on the planet. We thank you, God, that we are not just a usual church, or that we don't just exist, but we make our mark in the history of the planet called Earth. We are the history makers. God, we thank you that we are the church which changes lives. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus.
Baboya, Hakidayu, Hakababuro Kobo, Hikalabo Koru Kuru Kuru, Hakaru Kuru Kuru Kuru, Hikele Kere 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 Kere, Mababa Karabu Sonte, Hikabosa, Kila Baba Baba, Habaja MTBA.
We adore you. We lift you up high.
Spasiba.
Oh, thank you. That you start effects, we thank you. That you start shaking which will reach edges of the world, and we thank you for the footprint, for the mark which we leave. Thank you. The hearts of people, the hearts of nations, different continents and countries. And this conference will be about this. We will make the mark on the earth of Ukraine, in different countries and continents, and in the hearts of people, the footprint, the mark, which will live on eternally until Jesus has come and until a human being exists on the earth, our mark will live. Glory be to you, Jesus. We exalt you. And let's say together, Amen. Raise your voices to the Lord. Raise your voices with joy.
Haya la boro cosa baborondo, ki kere ya loro bika la boria la bo. Oh, baba baba boro bala borondo, hadele le le boro boro casa ya. Haya la boro boro coro boro borondo, iya la bo sende, me privaso sintebe, me bakwara.
We exalt you, and we worship you.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. What is given here?
книга.
This is a book. And the one who will not read this book, you may consider you, that you have never read any valuable book in life. How you can discover riches in yourself. This is the title of the book. I don't mean tangible riches. So every one of you can earn hundreds, thousands of dollars. Just read this book. This is evolutionary book. How to put plus from minus, how to turn plus from minus. This book is about the riches and values which are deep inside of you. Can you show the covers on the screen, please? It would be good to see them. So you are already rich. This is the book. So do you remember the book of University of Life, which is called Hooray, I'm a Woman? And I have written a new book for men. I am a man. I am a man. Look here. There are two exclamation marks here after the word I. I am a man. But, you know, our men usually walk like this, humped. They cannot stand with open shoulders and say, I am a man. You know, a Ukrainian man are waiting until a beautiful girl with a skirt comes and say what to do to him, you know. Until this is so, we'll never be a man. We must achieve that level that we could say, now I am a man. There will be an order in this house. There are 300 pages of educational process here. I am a man. Sorry, not educational, not edification, no. But how should I tell it in another way? Okay, so let's call it, you know, just a start. A sort of, you know, shake for the men. So you will be loaded with interesting information here. Edification is not good. Education is not good. Just a sort of, you know, instruction for the men. Do I not look like this one? You know, we cut out the head here on the cover for no one could say, oh, it's not me, it's Vasya there on the cover. This is what the why it's not me. But you could, you know, try this book on yourself. And 400 pages.